Hi everyone, welcome to Simplicity TV. I am Jen Pike, your host. If you've been following us over the last couple of weeks, you know this is part of my couch series. I love it because I haven't had to change my outfit in weeks now, according to you guys. We are batching these all out today, and I just came off running a webinar last night. We've come out of running a live event, Ignite Your Life, and so the questions, the comments, the feedback have just been beautiful and overwhelming all at the same time. And it gives me a great opportunity to have a lot of content to bring to all of you. Big question we get from the ladies who are part of our Simplicity community and the Hormone Project is around alcohol. Now, I'm sure you can assume what they're asking. Can I still have my wine? Can I still have my beer and my coolers and my spritzers? And if it's a time of year when you're watching this where it's beautiful outside and the patios are open, this tends to be that time of year where we do a little bit more destruction to ourselves in terms of our alcohol intake. So why is it such a big deal? Well, we know that alcohol as a whole is not good for the liver, but do you really know why? Your liver has over 500 daily jobs on a daily basis, okay, that need to be done regardless if you're male, female, young, or old. When you're a woman, though, you have additional tasks that your liver has to carry out because this is where you're metabolizing majority of your hormones. It is how you are going to be free from chemical toxic forms of estrogen. It is part of how you're going to be set up for healthy perimenopause and menopause and postmenopause. And you really have to start to think about that in your 20s and in your 30s, not when all of a sudden your cycles become irregular and now you're starting to think about those phases and changes in your life. Alcohol is also really detrimental to us because it throws our blood sugar out of whack. You know, when you have those cravings, like I don't know about you, but if I have more than one or two drinks, I'm like, oh, what is there to nibble on? And you're not looking for veggies and dip, you're looking for chips and dip. You're looking for sweets. You're having, you know, a bigger portion of a meal that you're drinking with. You know, it's also extremely high in estrogen, extremely high in estrogen. And it doesn't matter what type of alcohol we're talking about. If you're drinking something like beer, or you're having coolers, or you're having wine, or you're having something like vodka and tonic or rum and coke, where the thing that is being added to the alcohol is higher in sugar, higher in preservatives, then that is obviously going to make things worse because now you've got this double whammy. You've got alcohol in and of itself, which is high in estrogen, but then you also have the sugars, which are high in sugar, that are going to impact your liver health and also impact your estrogen levels. And it's going to increase the amount of fat that your body is storing as well too, because your blood sugar is unstable, insulin levels are going to be all over the map. And insulin is your body's fat storing hormone. Now, the more fat cells you have on your body, you are not only going to produce more fat cells, but you hold all your toxins inside those fat cells. The more fat cells that you have, the stronger they get over the years. You also produce estrogen out of these fat cells. So your body literally starts to become its own fat producing system. So if you're going to have drinks, what are some of the cleaner choices that you could be having? How much and how often? My bigger question to you would be, why are you drinking? Are you drinking so that you don't have to feel what you're feeling? Are you drinking because it's how you stuff stress deeper into your body? Are you drinking because everybody around you drinks? Is it a social thing? Are you drinking because to you, you've negotiated this thing where you're like, I eat healthy, I exercise, you know, I do everything for everyone else. This is my one way that I unwind. Are you drinking because this is how you and your spouse connect? Right? These are a lot of, you know, real reasons as to why women are bringing more alcohol into their lives. So that'd be my first question. The answer to that would be, obviously we want to be choosing something like organic dry red wines if you're going to choose wine. If you're going to choose hard liquor, using something like vodka, Ciroc I think is the best one because it's also gluten-free. So it's not going to irritate your gut as much. With soda, fresh citruses, lemons and limes, which actually reduce the acidity and make the alcohol more alkalizing for your body. And then how much should you be having? I mean, I think we know the answer to this. No more than 1 to 2 glasses. And ladies, if you're having more than 4 servings of alcohol in a week, you are increasing your risk of estrogen dominant cancers, primarily breast cancer, by more than 30%. If you are having more than 6 to 7 servings of alcohol in a week, you are doubling that risk. So you really need to think about this. We'll think about alcohol as impacting our waistline. You need to think about this impacting you on a cellular and a hormone and a detoxification level as well too. It goes much deeper than that. So as you move into your evening, into the rest of your week and your weekend, really ask yourself, why am I choosing to drink? How often is it happening? How much am I having when I drink? And what could be some healthier, better options? And do mocktails. I have found over the years, I love a good glass of wine. I probably enjoy one, maybe two glasses of wine a week. In the summer, I might have something like a vodka soda. I'm not a huge drinker. My body doesn't tolerate it anymore. I feel like garbage. My skin will react. I get this kind of like cobwebby feeling in my body. My palate changes. I hold on to retention. All of those things are your body's signs and symptoms of telling you, girl, you have got inflammation. And if you keep doing this, I'm gonna keep pounding the inflammation on your body and you're gonna see the effects of that. So I just put like my water with ice and lemon and lime and frozen organic berries into a wine glass. Like I make the glass itself be fun and I still am sipping on something when we're entertaining friends in that, but it's not always alcohol. So think about that too, you know. Fancy up your water, have a mocktail, reduce your sugar, still have the social experience, but really look at how you can be reducing that alcohol intake. And again, I'm not your mama. I'm not gonna say to you, you are not allowed. You are a big girl and you can make that conscious choice, but I think if you know better, that you might choose better for yourself. All right, cheers. Have an awesome rest of your day.